Hey everyone, welcome back. One of the coaches of Unger Academy here. And today we're going to be talking about Amazon and more specifically about a very simple and effective trading system that seems to be able to ride the most important bullish movements on this market. We're going to be building a strategy based on breakout entries that lead to more interesting results than a traditional buy and hold. What you see here is the result of the trading system, and we're going to be building it from scratch together. As always, before we begin, I invite you to leave us a like if you haven't already done so, subscribe to our channel, and click on the notification bell. Hi, we are the Unger Academy, and we teach traders how to make money in the markets. Our founder, Andrea Unger, had been struggling with trading for years until he developed his automated trading method, which he used to become the only four-time world trading champion. Subscribe to our channel for free tips and tricks. As I've already mentioned, we're going to be looking for a breakout operation. Now, this means riding on a market trend that has just formed, and then we'll manage the positions through a symmetrical exit based on the same approach of the market entry. There will then be a precautionary take profit and stop loss. So let's see together what the code is. Here it is. I mean, you can see it's very simple. Just a few lines of code. Now, let's review it together quickly. We have inputs dedicated precisely to the monetary amount of the stop loss and take profit. You can see here that they are set to 0.02 and 0.07 because we're going to be inserting them together with the input my capital, namely the capital that we're going to invest for each trade. The resulting monetary value obtained by multiplying my capital by stop loss or by take profit will be the monetary amount of the stop loss and take profit of each trade. Indeed, you can see that here we are using the set stop position command, which indicates the monetary stop of the whole trade. Going forward in the code, we have the variable my size, which is used to determine how many shares we're going to buy in each entry. In this case, you see that it's 100,000, which means $100,000 divided by the closing bar price. So we're going to decide how many shares to buy based on the counter value of the position, which will be $100,000. Then there is a filter based on the previous day's candlestick. For now, we'll leave it at 1. So this DF, or daily factor, we'll leave it equal to 1 as input, and later on we'll be able to optimize it. You can see that this daily factor coincides with the ratio between the body and the range. Of course, the body is always, going to be less than the range, so saying that this part of the code is less than 1 automatically implies a condition that's always true. So it says, well, it's as if this filter didn't exist. Once this condition is met and given a time range, meaning a trading time window, we'll buy at the breakout of the highs of the current session. After that, as I said, there will be a symmetrical exit on the lowest price of the current session. So let's start by studying a setup that we could call and define standard, namely our monetary amount per position of $100,000, a stop loss at 2%, a larger take profit, larger of 4%, and the entry times at 10 a.m. and 3:30 p.m. respectively. So why these 2 hours? Well, because they coincide exactly within half an hour of the opening of the market and half an hour before the end of the cash session. Remember that these are always exchange times. So we give our system the opportunity to process at least the first 30-minute bar, which runs from 9:30 to 10 a.m., to determine what our breakout entry will be. So let's look at this first result. The equity is already very interesting. The total trade analysis, however, tells us that the average trade you see here of $300 would coincide with about 0.3% of the trading counter value. It is still quite low. Commission costs are very low. Even slippage on this type of action should not involve any type of risk. However, we could still work on it in order to isolate the most important trades, namely the trades that make us earn more, maybe by excluding the potentially negative trades. Let's see with an optimization what are the effects of modifying the operative time window. So let's test different entry times, ranging from 10 a.m. to, let's say, 12:45 p.m. or maybe even 1 p.m. Let's also vary every 15 minutes the part related to the minutes. Now we can do the same with the end of the time window. We could start it maybe from 2 p.m. until 3:45 p.m. We'll do the same with the minutes and the hours. Let's launch this optimization. There are 128 combinations, so it really takes very little time. Let's order the results by net profit. I'm going to take a look both at the drawdown and the average trade. You'll see that compared to the $300 from which we started at the beginning, not only do we earn more, but we also increase our average trade. But let's see what the hours are. Let's look for an acceptable and therefore fairly robust level. For example, we can take this level, which starts at 10:45 a.m. Instead of 10 a.m. and ends at 2:30 p.m. instead of 3:30 p.m. Now, we would then get an average trade of around $435. Still not, very high, but the equity line has definitely improved. What we could do now is to figure out if the filter that we've prepared on the daily bar of the day before our entries could help us in some way. So using the same parameters found above, let's optimize our daily factor starting from 0 to 1 with a step of 0.1. Now let's adjust the values that we found. So 10:45 a.m. and 10:30 p.m. And let's launch these 11 combinations. Let's see if this filter is actually effective or not. Remember that we're starting from 1, so with many trades, 0 filter, and an average trade of about $435. You can see that as we go to filter the entries, thus decreasing the number of trades that are executed, the average trade seems to increase. We've got 35, 44, 68, and then it increases until we get to 650, 625, and 645. Then it goes down. But here we're already talking about 100 trades and 200 trades, so the effect obviously starts to wear off. I would stay with 0.5, which is a halfway value. It isn't the best in absolute as an average trade, as you can see here, 645, but it certainly shows us and allows us to make more trades and to earn more money. Not as much as 0.6, but that's a personal choice. I prefer a slightly larger average trade with fewer trades, even if it earns slightly less. Now let's go get this setup choice. Now the equity we got isn't bad at all. The average trade is reaching almost 1%. We're now at 0.65. As I said, slippage costs and commissions aren't included at the moment, but they shouldn't affect this kind of action too much. Once again, simplicity has rewarded us. Because remember that this strategy is made up of very few lines of code. It employs a very simple operational filter, a time window, and an entry based on a really very simple trigger. Well, I hope I've aroused your curiosity. You can examine it further, perhaps by adding another filter, or why not by varying the triggers? For example, you could switch to using triggers related to the high or low of the previous day and not of the current session. In short, Amazon seems to be a good choice for this kind of breakout approach. We really hope this video was helpful. And hey, if you need any help to start investing in the markets with a systematic approach, just like the one that we've just shown in this video, I'd suggest that you click on the link below. It'll take you to a page full of very useful resources. You can sign up for a free presentation by Andrea Unger, our founder and the only four-time world champion of real money trading. You can get our best-selling book, The Unger Method, paying only postage, or even book a free call with a member of our team for a free consultation. Finally, I'd like to remind you, if you haven't already done so, please subscribe to our channel and click on the notification bell to stay updated on the release of all our new content. And if you like this video, hey, leave us a like. And with that, we will see you soon in our next video. Until then, bye-bye.